guys, so right here we have the Meitu M8, and looking at the packaging, it reminds me of the days when I used to unbox Huawei devices. I mean the ones before the P20 Pro, before the boxes became so much smaller. And honestly, in my opinion, I prefer this packaging over, just say, the latest iPhone, the latest Samsung, because I feel that it adds a lot more value, a lot more class, and a lot more experience when unboxing the device. So I got this actually at a pretty good price. It was going for around 290 odd ringgit at the flash sale a couple of days back. And considering the price of this phone like about 3 to 4 years back, this one used to retail for a minimum of 1,699 ringgit. And buying a phone like this, a new brand, of course Meitu makes apps, but however, bringing into consideration that this is one of their very first devices, I wouldn't shell out so much money for a great import set, or to be called an AP set in Malaysia, because if I'm going to spend almost 1,700 ringgit and above, I would definitely want to have local warranty. But at that time, local warranty wasn't available. But however, this is a local Meitu Malaysia warranty unit, and spending so much less and having local warranty, I mean, that's a no-brainer at all. Alright, so let's take a look at the packaging. You have a very nice matte black box. So on the front here, you get a sort of a rose gold embossed shape of the device. So you can see M8, Meitu smartphone, and some Chinese wordings. Alright, so taking a look to the side, you can see Meitu branding. I'm sure on both sides, yes. Okay, and on the back, you can see the configuration I got this in. So this is the 64GB version, color is ivory. Alright, let's take a look at the unboxing experience. Alright, so unfolding the sleeve. Alright, so on the inside, you can see Meitu M8. Okay, and on the right side, let me unfold this. Very interesting packaging. I'm trying to fit this on the camera. Right here, you get the SIM ejector tool. You get a QR code, in fact. Not sure what that is. And then you get what comes in the box. So you can see where you can pause that and read it for yourself. So all in Mandarin. And then finally, you have something in English. So this is the warranty terms and conditions. So yes, very elaborate packaging. And I do like this kind of packaging. It gives me a good feeling when I'm unboxing a device. Alright, so here you get a nice microfiber cloth, in fact embossed microfiber cloth. I do like all this attention to detail in the packaging, and I really miss the times when we used to have much more stuff to unbox. Alright, so let's focus on the device itself. Alright, so right here we can see the device. I have this in white and also rose gold, and of course they call it ivory. Very nice. We'll get back to the phone a bit later. I actually did try to power this on, and the phone is basically dead, because considering that this phone has been sitting there for a couple of years now. So let's take out the top portion. All right, let's start with the first box. So this is the case, obviously. Let's open it and take a quick look. So when it comes to China devices, usually you get everything that you need to start off. So as you expected, this is the screen protector. Let me try to get this out of the packaging. So you have a screen protector already in the box, so you do not have to go online and start looking for a screen protector and probably take a couple of weeks to arrive. So you have a screen protector to get you all started, and I think this screen protector is adequate. And last but not least, you have a TPU case, a soft TPU case, which is good enough. I'm not going to ask for too much. Alright, so right here you have the USB Type-C cable. This phone, however, supports USB Type-C, which I consider pretty up to date. Of course, it's not the fastest charging speed, but it's good enough. It's better than micro USB any day. Alright, so let's see what comes in this box. All you get is a USB-C cable, which I have danced around. I'm not gonna open that. I'm gonna try to keep this boxing as quick as possible. Alright guys, so we have the power adapter right here. I'm not sure whether you can see the wattage. Alright, so right here we can see some Chinese wordings. You can see M8, you can see the huge top and bottom bezels. Of course, the bottom bezel contains your home button, something like the iPhone, and two capacitive buttons as well on the right and left. Alright, so on the top, let's take a closer look. We have the noise cancellation microphone, as well as your SIM card slot. This does not have expandable storage, so if your 64GB is not enough for you, that's it. So I wish they actually had the 128GB. I would have shelled out another 50 to 60 ringgit if they had. Alright, so on the bottom, we have the primary microphone, 3.5mm auxiliary port, which is, I mean, very hard to find these days. And then we have a USB-C charging port as well as speaker grill. So this is a mono speaker setup. You're not going to expect dual speakers back then, like 4 to 5 years back. Right, so on the front, we get, I bet it's a light sensor. or a notification LED, I'm not really sure about that. I get the grill as well. So in the center, we get a 21 megapixel camera, if I'm not mistaken. And then on the right side, we get a selfie flash as well. And then we have a 5.2 inch AMOLED panel. I mean, for 200 plus, you're getting an AMOLED panel. And basically, this phone, I'm going to be using it for social media and stuff like that. So more than adequate. And it does have some weight to it as well. So 170 grams if you're interested. And take a look at the back, we have the same 21 megapixel camera that's on the front, except it's on the rear. They have two, and then you have two LED flash, so which means that you get a very balanced and even image when you're using the flash, which is pretty ingenious, something like the TCL Plex, which I reviewed a couple of months back. Alright, so here you get the Meitu branding as well, and basically that's about it. On the side, we get a selfie button as well as the power button. On the left, we get the volume rocker, usual affair, and basically that's about it. So this has a aluminium frame going around it, sandwiched between glass. So overall, I'm very happy with the build quality. It's thin, it has some weight to it, and it feels solid overall in the hand. And for this price range, I will take this over any other Lenovo phone, for example, which feels like cheap plastic. So I think this quality is really very good, and I do like the feel of it. Alright, so on the inside, we get the MediaTek Helio X20, which has a deca core, so it's 10 cores. Of course, it sounds fancy, but back in the day, not so power efficient. And you know it's a MediaTek processor, so you're not going to expect like Snapdragon level performance. So this also has a 3000 mAh hour battery, and it's running on Android 6.0 Marshmallow, so you're not going to expect like the latest Android OS. So this has Bluetooth 4.1 as well. So overall, I think this phone is still very relevant in 2021. And considering the price, I don't think there's anything much to complain about. Currently, the price without flash sale promo is going for around 319 ringgit, 319 to 320 excluding shipping. Yeah, the screen is a bit outdated, it's a bit small, 5.2 inches. We're used to the 6 plus inches devices for screen size. When you consider the value for money, I think this phone is definitely the way to go. Alright, so this has been a very quick unboxing. I do love packagings like this. Please, brands, bring back packaging like this. Of course, yes, storage wise, when they ship it, it's not so cost efficient, but when it comes to the user experience, I do like these kind of unboxings. Alright, so this has been a very quick unboxing. If you did like the video, give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel for more content just like this, and I'll see you guys in the next